I've never been a mailman before, but something that I do know is that if you leave mail out in the rain, it might get destroyed. That's something I'm not sure my mail carrier knows, and I'd like to send them a letter, but I don't think I have any waterproof paper. So hopefully, all the damage to this package that was sent to me by Big Nate Energy is all external, and everything inside is just fine. But there's only one way to find out. Here I am on the floor because this box is too big for my desk. I got my handy master sword, let's get into it. Alright, time to open this Crown Zenith ETB. It's only the second ETB I've ever opened. And through the magic of editing, look what we can do. Pretty cool, huh? Look, I can do it again. That was pretty fun. Alright, let's open this thing up. Alright, here it is. One of my favorite sets that I've opened in a while. And some of the best pulls I've had have been from this set. So it's kind of fun to open that up. Plus, I needed another ETB for storage. I wanted to buy one just because I like the containers. So here we go. I'm going to start opening these. No rhyme or reason. Let's just see what we get. This video is partially... Oops. Partially just to show Nate what we got. Messaged me on Twitter and we talked a little bit and he said he'd like to see what was in here. Hopefully not something too good. I know it's not what we're usually looking for, but you know, he's that'd be rough if I sent something out. Oh, Mareep, starting off with a banger. I'm not sure if we have this one yet, but that's part of the nine piece puzzle. Oops. So let's sleeve that up as our first hit. But yeah, if I was the one giving away an ETB and then someone pulled like a gold card or something, I don't know. That might be hard to watch. Speaking of that, well, some of these are really tough to open. I don't know why that would be. Oh, first let me say our goal for today. Usually we have a silly goal to go for. Last time I opened an ETB, it was what we called Winter 2 here in Minnesota. We have winter, and then just when you think it's going to be spring, suddenly Winter 2 happens, and you get a nice blizzard somewhere in April or March. So I was searching for fire, so today I'm looking for... Wow! Okay, I know I don't have that one. So it looks like we're just going to get a piece of the puzzle in every pack. That would be nice. And we got the bead, or however you say, bede. autograph card. Those are fine. Anyway, so we were looking for fire to keep us warm, kind of our hook back then. I know this is the hardest one of these to get, so that's exciting. Today, it's actually only a few days from the hottest day of the year. So it's been a while since we opened an ETB. So we're going to be looking for... I'll put some pictures on the screen right here of some of the cards we're looking for today. Stuff to keep us cool. That was actually going to be my hook for the day, but then getting water on my mail made me think, I don't know if I want more water. But I'm actually keeping the code cards for myself today. I usually give them away, but I've been playing a lot of the online game. And it's been fun getting... online packs and not having to open quite as many because you can just kind of open the ones on there. We got a reverse, we got the metal energy, wow. And then of course we got an Asaka Ito. Snorlax, always good with the Pokemon Sleep coming out, that's timely. This is actually the only holographic energy I've ever gotten was metal energy, so we'll go in a trade binder or I don't know. Giveaway, maybe I'll do a giveaway or something. Speaking of which, we do have a running giveaway right now. It's this green mystery box, nice dingy green box. We're giving it away to somebody. I will put the information in the description of how to enter that giveaway. It's just a mystery box putting together myself, so let's get through this. I'm not used to opening this many packs at once. Oh, I think I saw something in there. Let's see if we got something. Got the reverse Riolu and another Regigigas.
62 cents. I'll take the money.
I do like Regigigas a lot, the cards in this set at least. But I think this is my second one of these, and I've also got two of the V-Star ones, but I'll still put that in the hit pile. Like I said, I've been playing the game more online, which means I've also been... Ooh, this one feels nice. It's hard to explain. So I've also been trying to make decks in real life and everything, so... I keep doing that. I know it's overplayed, but like, man, the difference between Scarlet and Violet and getting used to the pack trick is throwing me off. Our first Radiant Charizard. This is actually a big moment right here. I have never pulled a Charizard before. Ever. Like, since the beginning of... you know, 26 years ago or whatever. I used to have a base set Charizard when I was younger. I don't think I pulled it, but I think I traded up for it. And I've told the story a couple times. But there was a kid that taught me how to cross my eyes in exchange for my Charizard. And I was stupid, so I said, sure, that's an important life skill. And ever since then, I've been trying to pull a Charizard. I have not been able to. So I know this isn't the most expensive one ever, but it is, it's a cool Charizard, and I think it's playable. I've seen people use it. Very nice card. And I don't have that one, obviously, but it's also a shiny one, so I still never pulled a regular one. So I have purchased ones before, or just kind of came across them in trades, but I've never pulled one. And the great thing is, doesn't look like the pack's done. What do we got back here? Zamazenta V, so just a regular old... decent pull, but that Radiant Charizard is nice. So when we were trying to stay warm back in March, I was unable to pull anything. Not to spoil that video, but it's been out for a while. Unable to pull anything at all heat-wise. I didn't even get any fire energies. It was actually hilariously bad. And now that I'm trying to pull something nice and cool to keep me cool, suddenly I get a Charizard. So I figured out I basically have to do water energy, at least. Basically have to want the opposite of what I get. So it's fine. I just never get my chase cards. I never find anything that I want. I have pulled gold from this set before, and I've pulled gold from other sets before too, and none of those times was I looking for those things. So, or Choreo, that's a, and another one of these. Again, yeah, not one that I was looking for. I've often wondered. I know Real Breaking Nate. He does not like Or Choreo, but I've often wondered what he feels about this card, and if somehow he saw this video. I'd love for him to let me know. That would be insane, by the way. But if he did, I want to know what he thinks about this. It's got to be because his favorite artist is Tomokazu Kamiya. Talks about it all the time. Great artwork, but it's a card he doesn't seem to like at all, or a Pokemon he doesn't like. So, I should have done that. Real Breaking Nate fans will understand why I did that. All right. Got four more packs. I'm not sure what the guaranteed hits are in something like this, but I'd say we've probably already gotten plenty that I'm happy with at this point, especially since it was 100% free for me. Really, you should go look up right after this. You can leave now if you want. I'll still be here. The video will be here when you get back. You should go and follow Real Breaking Nate. Not Real Breaking Nate, sorry. Other Nate. Big Nate Energy. And there was a point in time when I think when I followed him, me and him had about the same amount of subscribers, and he just launched up. It just kind of, you know, my theory is I've got kind of a gravelly graveler voice. Nice. And, you know, he's got a smooth, deep voice. So, hey, Greedent. I don't have that one. So, you know, that's probably contributes to it. You know, he makes good content too, and he does it regularly. So I've been following him for a while, and kind of shocked when I saw it, actually just on a random short. I was just watching shorts, and his popped up, and it was like, oh, doing a redraw for this giveaway. I didn't remember I even entered, but my name popped up, and I got very, very excited. So I've been looking forward to this all week. I'll put his information in the description. He does a pack battle, I think twice a week. Sharon's Care, full art trainer. That honestly might be the hit of the day. Again, one I never really thought I wanted, but looking at it now, you got the texture, and you got the little Liepard in the back. Yeah, just cool card. Definitely sleeve that up, give it a top loader, put it in my favorites section. See if we can get the second to last pack magic. I think the, I don't know, obviously I want the cold. I want something cold to keep us, you know, cool this summer, but I have been trying to pull that Pikachu for so long. That is the one that I want. And I just feel like everybody is pulling it at this point. And again, told the story before, but I searched for it, and I searched for it, and I decided this will be the card. This is my ultimate chase card, Crown Zenith. I just want that Pikachu, secret rare. And it's not here. I just want that Pikachu secret rare, but decided, you know, maybe it's not going to happen. So I actually purchased it. I was buying some cards already. Just buying a couple, I don't remember what I was buying at the time, but I purchased it, and I waited and waited and waited, and it never came. Still hasn't come. This was months ago. I think they forgot about me. I probably should, if someone knows what you're supposed to do if that happens, I don't really know who to talk to, but if it's not in this pack, I feel like I gotta complain, because, or you know what, maybe I'll just have to decide. You know, I'm going to give this one away. If you want that one, you take it. I already got 9 other ones, but this has been really fun. Hopefully we can end on something good. I just want to give another thank you to Big Nate Energy for doing a giveaway in the first place. And Bidoof, that's playable. Potion. Mr. Mime. Finally got a different reverse holo energy card, and ended on a sky seal stone. Actually a solid last pack. None of them had the Pikachu, none of them had anything, you know, ice related. I really wanted that Samurott, I think. I know it's not ice, but it's just like chilling in the water. So not the red one, but the Samurott where he's just chilling in the water. That was what I was hoping for, but what we got here is actually pretty sweet. We'll do a quick recap. All right, here are the lesser cards. I don't know if they're lesser, but they're the ones I was a little less excited about. And then I'll put the prices on the screen here. And then here's some of the ones I was a little bit more excited about. Especially that Radiant Charizard being my first Charizard ever. That Pikachu I know is the hardest one to get. Sharon's Care. Just cool trainer. Amazing artwork on that one. First, I like Tomokazu as well. Zamasenta V. Might make a deck out of it because I have more of those. And the Mareep, other piece of the puzzle. So just overall a good hit. I'll put it on the screen if I made my money back. If I did, whether I did or didn't, you should go subscribe to Big Nate Energy. And then if you're not a subscriber here, feel free to subscribe as well. And then check the description for that giveaway. All right. Have a good day. Have a good rest of your week, and see you around.